Well, China is emerging as a powerful country, and it claims now to be, I would say, another global power. But certainly, it has emerged as a regional power in the region. So it is becoming assertive. And how do we deal with them? You see, with the dealing with him is a whole of a government approach. We cannot say that the army alone will deal with China. So therefore, what is happening is, one is of course your direct diplomatic, you know, engagement with China that is happening. It is happening. That I would say the diplomatic engagement with China is happening rather well, and that is one of the ways to ensure that peace and tranquility is maintained. At the military level, we know that if there is a threat from China, we have to be prepared for it. And therefore, that action is being taken to ensure that our preparations go on. I have always said that our focus on the has to shift on the northern borders. For too long, we've kept our focus on the western front. And now I think time has come for us to also focus on the northern border. So therefore, our infrastructure development in the northern border has to be speeded up. Our requirement of systems that we have to ginger up for that. We have to start preparing for the next kind of warfare that we will be faced with. And that involves cyber information. So we have to start gingering up for that. To say that, you know, just because we are deployed on the borders and that it's going to be an attrition warfare, the China man is going to come rolling down the hills, it may not happen. The warfare may be, war may be fought differently. So we have to start preparing for that, and we have started giving a thought to that. The most important aspect that we have to deal with is our neighborhood. I think we cannot allow the neighborhood to be drifted away from us. Whether it is Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, you know, Bangladesh or Sri Lanka, or what have you, Afghanistan, these nations have to be kept on board, and I think we have to put in our wholehearted effort to ensure that we continue to support them. Let me tell you, at the military level, our engagements with all these nations are of a very high order. In fact, we are concentrating more on the neighborhood than going beyond that. And therefore, that is one issue we find, that if we can keep these nations with us, we would be able to make sure that the assertiveness that China is doing against us is balanced in some way. So it's going to be, that is the approach we are taking. We understand China is a powerful country, but let us also not forget we are not a weak nation. So let's not get so worried, and the way we are dealing with the situation, we are confident we'll be able to handle the situation.